guys, and welcome back to another Trains and World 2 video. Today we're going to be playing another scenario on the Bakerloo Line. The scenario we're going to be playing is the Bakerloo Line High Speed scenario. So basically we're going to be driving a GWR Class 43 plus Mark 3 coaches times 4 from Harren Wolvesden to Elephant and Castle, southbound sidings, making 3 stops along the way. I believe the 3 stops are Queen's Park, Piccadilly Circus and Elephant and Castle. So yeah, let's get started. I have bought a brand new microphone. It's the Elgato Wave 3, so hopefully my voice should be a lot more clearer and better, as I've heard good things about this microphone. But yeah, let's get started. Let's unlock the doors. Right, let's put the unlock the master key. Put that into neutral for now. Yeah, coming out at Harrow and Wolvesden. Let me just quickly put the lights on before I forget. Yeah, we're on platform. Is this platform 2, I think? As platform 1 is a terminating for the Bakerloo Line, so yeah. That's pretty cool. Let's take a screenshot, why not? Too sure why we're going forward, but okay. No, let's put the brake on. That was weird. Right, that's not the doors. Right. Yeah, we are slightly down though, so that's probably why. Let's go to forward and let's get going. Right, next station is Queen's Park. So if you do want to play this scenario, you will need the Bakerloo Line Route and the GWR Route because of the train, and yeah, it should be good to play this scenario. From the Creator Club, I think it's called. One thing to note is there's a speed limit, obviously, so even though this train can go up to 125 miles an hour, we can only drive to the speed limit. It's got slightly faster. So we should hopefully see some Bakerloo Line trains, as you would expect on the Bakerloo Line, but this is just a special high speed service calling at Queen's Park, Piccadilly Circus and Elephant and Castle. Yeah, the train is not that long, so we should be able to fit it on the platforms, I think. We'll see. I see a Bakerloo Line there. Let's try a nice screenshot, why not? If we can. The camera is just really bad in this game, so probably not. I'm a Metropolitan Line tracks. I was wondering what tracks we were on, but that's a bit weird. We are speeding, so let's just. We need to put some brake. Okay, I don't want that one. There we go. As we approach South Kensington. Not not sure if we're gonna have any overground AI trains. I don't think so, because there's only like two requirements for this to play this scenario, which is the Bakerloo line and class 43 train, so that's it. Yeah, it's been a while since I've driven a class 43. I can't remember the last time I've done so. It's probably like since, like, I guess Trains and World 1 came out, probably. Because you have to remember that this train and the GWR came out when the first Trains and World game came out, so. Whereas the Bakerloo line came out with Trains and World 2, so. It's been a while. I mean, I have seen quite a lot of cool scenarios from the Creator Club, so I will be playing a bunch of them, as long as I have the requirements, so stay tuned for that. Yeah, it feels a bit annoying that we can only drive 45 miles an hour in this train, but maybe like the person who made this now should have maybe just changed the speed limits if he could, so he can drive a bit more faster, since this is a high speed service. So. But anyways, I think we're coming up to Wembley Central. Let's go a bit faster. And we're still on a 0.3% down gradient, so. Oh, we need to stop actually. 600 yards. As we go underneath the West Coast Main Line, we will be going downhill, so we should keep an eye on the speed limit. Stadium in the background. As we pass, I think this is Halton Station, I believe. I should know this because this is my local underground line, so I think we should start slowing down. As we approach Wilson Junction. Bakerloo Line Junction. Probably why you're not seeing any AI on the West Coast mainland is because I don't think you can add any AI. I think when they made the route there, they kind of blocked it or something, so that's probably why you don't see anything on the West Coast mainland, which is very unfortunate. I'm not too sure if there's a way to do that, but I'm sure if you could add AI trains on the West Coast mainland, they would, because it just makes sense. Should be approaching Queen's Park, which we are going to be stopping at. I don't think there's like a time that we need to arrive there. Doesn't look like it. Feels like a bit more of a low speed train than a high speed train. That's for sure. It might be driving a high speed train, but I'm definitely not like driving at high speed. And obviously once you get into the underground part, then the speed limit will be even less overall. Gradients. This is Queen Spark, change here for the Bakerloo Line and London Overground services. As you probably know from the last video, I'm on a new account because I lost my old one because of the new computer, so it's basically like everything's been reset, which is very annoying. So we'll take a screenshot if I can. Let's get going. Oops. Alright, next station is Piccadilly Circus, only 3.5 miles away. Deep into the tunnel. I literally can't see anything. Let's put the cab lights on. As we pass Kilburn Park. Yeah, these 3 miles will feel very fast because we're not stopping at any other stations. One thing you'll probably notice is like we're really high up. Also, the Bakerloo Line is like a low down train, but like this is like a high speed train and it's like it's quite high up, so the platforms feel like very like the platform difference between like getting off the train from this train onto the platform being quite big. Should be quite funny to see. The thing is, like, if when you get off the overground service at Wilton Junction, like, the platform difference is like huge. This is Warwick Avenue. Change it for Little Venice. Station will be Paddington, where this train would normally depart from, but it's arriving on the underground part, so Road. I say that arriving at Piccadilly Circus would be fast, I mean snow. It's probably fast to drive in the Bakerloo line. I would probably say that on this train, because it would accelerate a lot faster than this train, especially at low speed, so. Speed limits, which I don't think matters too much. Yeah, you can see how high this train is. Like, we're touching the ceiling basically, all those beams. this? Regent's Park, I believe. I believe next station should be Oxford Circus. Circus. It's Oxford Circus. Next station is Piccadilly Circus. We can change for the Piccadilly line. And Bakerloo line. Approaching Piccadilly Circus. Surely, but gradually. Look how big this train is, guys. Holy That's what you call a Bakerloo line. So the screenshot we're taking. Imagine us walking down here and then seeing this train. It's huge high-speed service train. I mean, it's not that bad actually. On this, like, platform's quite high up, so... I mean, the roof, so... It doesn't look that bad. Obviously, there's a massive step to get on, but... It's pretty cool. Alright, I need to climb up the stairs because we're so high up. Next station is Elephant and Castle. So right. So next station should be Charing Cross. to approach Charing Cross. Bank one, which is just around the corner. I really like Waterloo Station on the Bakerloo Line because of the curved nature of the platform. It's really cool. However, there's a massive gap between the train and the platform, especially when you jump onto the train at the front. So, actually at the rear on this platform and I guess at the front on the other platform because of its curves. So, you do need to watch yourself so you don't just like fall into the gap. Lambeth North and then Elephant and Castle, which is just around the corner. Now approach Elephant and Castle, this train terminate, all change. So I believe we are going to be taking the train to the sidings, southbound sidings, so got a little bit extra after this. let's get off. Oops. Very nice screenshot. Yeah, we got Twin Castle, Nova 9. I guess apart from like these parts, like, it doesn't look that out of place to have a high-speed train on the Bakerloo line. Let's get going to the southbound sidings. Here's the 10 miles an hour speed limits. If it asks me, but we'll take it. Yeah, there we go. Leveling up nicely. I was like level 30, but as you can see, I'm on a new account with underscores, so yeah. It's a bit unfortunate, but yeah. That was another scenario from the Creator Club. Hopefully, you guys enjoyed it. If you did, give it a like, share with your friends, and I will see you in my next video. Bye, guys.